is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you on a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. What's good, YouTube? Back at it again. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to y'all a quick video. We're going to talk about Wilson Chandler going to the most exciting team right now in the NBA other than the Pacers and the Jazz, the Brooklyn Nets. They get Wilson Chandler for basically nothing. 1 year, 2.6. Ooh, he ain't really get nothing this year. He got paid a couple years ago, and now he's taking a flyer with the Nets. The Nets need somebody like him. They got Caris LeVert. They obviously got Rondé. They got some wings, but when you look at this team, Taurean Prince is 6'8". Allen Williams is 6'8", but they still need those wings until Kevin Durant go down, and this gives them another player that can shoot the ball from the three-point line, play within his role. He's an unselfish player. He does what the team asks him. Also, he gives them depth at that position because some of these guys you might want to play at the four. He's one of those guys that can play a small ball four for you and give you that floor space. And plus, when you have guys like Prince, who's probably going to get majority of those minutes, you still got other guys that they don't know what they're going to do with or who they're going to bring in. But when you get Wilson Chandler, you know you're going to get a veteran that played in playoff games, that gives a toughness that you can't really buy. It's something that he naturally does. And I always had a thing for Wilson Chandler. I feel like he was one of those guys that if he was on the right team in the right situation, he can make a difference. He's that good of a player. And we even seen that when he got traded. A lot of teams was trying to get him because they know that he brings that wing position, three-point shooter that can also do other things like scoring the basketball. So I like Wilson Chandler for them. You're not paying them anything like we've done seen with a lot of these contracts. You're not giving them the long-term commitment. He's on a cheap contract and it's tradable. And at worst, you can waive him and use the roster spot for somewhere else. But at the end of the day, this is a great pickup for them. And like I said, even if Prince or anybody go down, Jefferson, if he comes, and Prince and LeVert, you got a guy that can come in there and give you scoring and give you a slight ability to play make and give you some length and some size. And he's going to give you effort and energy, and he's going to go out there and fight for you. So they got a veteran that is really tough, that can really be skilled. Got good touch, good athleticism, can get out in transition, can knock down threes in transition, can get to the basket. This is a cheap bargain buy. I didn't really think they'd get him for cheap like this. I thought he'd be worth at least $5 to $7 million on a good team, but he's on a good team and he's on a short-term deal, which I'm surprised too. I feel like he could have got a little bit more, like a 2 or 3 year deal, player option, team option from somebody else, or even got at least $5 to $7 million on a team like the Nets, and they're not going to complain because they get them cheap and no long-term commitment either. So I really want to see what they do with the rest of this roster. They got one of the younger up-and-coming roster, but it just ain't the same because they don't got KD this year. So you know that they're trying to still build a competitive team. They're still trying to show Kyrie and the rest of this team that we're still going to try to go out there and compete. And I feel like this is one of those moves that reassure them that they're not just here to just be around. They're here to try to win it. Even if KD's not going to play and we don't really know when he's going to come back, they're still giving a competitive team around Kyrie to still show that they're not just going to tank and give in on the season. We knew that, but they're still building the roster as if they're going to try to go for the playoffs and try to make some noise. So if they do or they don't, we won't know into the future. But with this pickup, this do help them out in that regard. And it does give them a guy that they needed, in my personal opinion, and a guy that's very versatile, can guard ones, twos, threes, and fours. And that's something that you really don't find when it comes to being able to shoot the three, plus bring other offensive abilities like slight playmaking and scoring. So this is still for them. Like I said, I thought he'd get more money and a longer, a better deal. But if I'm the Nets, I ain't complaining. So. I guess this is a steal for them.
Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos. Thanks for everybody that comments. I like the activity that you guys have shown. I answer comments that make sense, if that makes sense. And also, at the end of the day, if you like this video, check out my older videos on my channel. I have many playlists. I break down rookies. I break down players. I break down summer league. I do cover the draft, and I got a mock draft up already. Not only that, I do podcasts, and I also talk about the game of basketball, whether it comes to summer league, free agency, trade deadline, buyouts, and also I cover top 10 discussions and stuff like that. So you like this type of video, you like the NBA, check out my older videos and my playlists. I enjoy making these videos. You guys enjoy watching. I'm going.